FBI and CIA and everybody else in between. And they didn't have anything, they couldn't stop that. But she'd have had a gun. And now, and today, she's in a nationwide movement, working with the NRA to try to save our rights to have a gun. Now, you think about that. I had a woman, a young woman, to come and point a pistol in my face, cocked a hammer, and asked me if I was ready to die. Well, nobody's ready to die, but at 69 years old, I'm about done anyway. I don't worry about it a lot, because she doesn't scare me. So she said, I believe you want to die, and I'm not going to help you out. So she went on and did something else a lot worse. I mean, you know, if you haven't got it, and you need it, it's just like insurance. And I heard this tale about an old man who was 80-something years old. Highway patrol stopped him and asked him for his license, and he said, I ain't got none. And he said, well, how old are you? And he said, 82. How long have you been driving? Since I was big enough to sit on the side coach and see over the steering wheel. You mean you've been driving all these years and you ain't never had a license? And he said, well, I ain't needed there until now. Well, if you get in a situation and you need a gun and you ain't got none, well, you better be getting one.
When we look at, even though we've got gun laws, and I'll reiterate what I've said, I'm not saying that no one should have a gun, but how many places, even though we've got rights and things, how many places require and allow individuals to show up with guns? I go to some restaurants sometimes to eat, and they've got signs up. When I go to the bank, there are signs up. When I come here, there's signs up. You can't have them. Can't bring them in. And so the idea is that I'm not saying we can't have guns or whatever, but in certain situations there, we don't need them. We have to rely upon the goodwill of people there. Because if everybody's got a gun, how likely is it that someone winds up shooting themselves or shooting others or individuals who are not even good? How does Dollar know who the good guys are? I want to be there. I'm in some place and I've got a gun, the popo runs in, he doesn't know me from that. I could become a victim as a result of that. So I'm not saying that we should do away with guns. I've never said that. But I think that there is some ways that we can limit what we do and where we take them and those things. Because I hate to live in a police state where everywhere you go, you have to have a gun.
As I've said already, we can come up with all types of scenarios. Nothing trumps my right to life. Nothing trumps my right to self-defense. We can come up with all kinds of stories and ifs, ands, and buts. But I still say, in my mind, it's real simple. A good guy with a gun takes care of the bad guy with a gun. And that's the way it works. An armed society is a polite society. It's that simple.
Now we get into our emotions, I suppose, how we feel. And this restaurant, the gentleman spoke of, was named Libby's Restaurant. This woman, she carried a gun. It always stayed in her purse. And with the laws in Texas at that time, there was somewhere, even though she didn't get it out and play with it, check on it every 5 minutes, or even every day, she always carried that gun. And with the laws in Texas at the time, she had to go somewhere that was a gun-free zone. And she took it out and put it in the console of her vehicle. And that day that happened, her father, y'all will watch this video on YouTube and see the expressions on her face, because she's just like me. She's been affected directly. She knows what it feels like to not be able to protect yourself in a bad situation. She said her father looked at her and says, have you got it? And she said, no. She forgot to put it back in her purse. And the man was not going to stand idly by and let this crazy individual just continue killing people. And somehow he stood up to fight a fight, and the man shot and killed him. And this so happens, it wasn't a birthday party, it was an anniversary party. I forget the years, but I think it was right at 50, 60 years. It was an anniversary of him and his wife, and they were there. And about the time a window broke and everybody started rushing out the window to get away from this crazy gunman, the daughter grabs her mother by the arms and says, "Come on, let's go." And I think her exact words was, "I felt wings, I just flew." And when she got outside, she realized her mother wasn't with her. Her mother wasn't gonna leave the man that she'd been with for 50 something years laying there dying. And she stayed there right beside him. She saw the man, saw her mother raise up and look at the man as he shot and killed her as well. No, we can't stop somebody that wants to sneak in behind us and pull a gun out and pop it in our head and kill us right then. Never will be able to. Not if they planted it. But hopefully you can stop them from doing it to somebody else. Maybe my child or my wife. And that's why I feel so adamant about it. Also, just to reiterate, there was something said earlier about you have to have a license to drive a vehicle. You don't have to have a license to move around and go different places in our country that's protected. Driving a vehicle is not a protected right. The right to bear arms is. And that thing shall not be infringed. No, you don't have the right to drive a vehicle. You earn that. You're born with the right to bear arms in our country.
Well, I can't help but say that one quick thing. The statement that if a person wants to do me in, there's absolutely nothing I can do about it, is so wrong. So wrong. Is it possible that there would be nothing I could do about it? Yes. But it's not probable. I've been professionally trained. I feel like that I can defend myself.
This next question is really more for Sheriff Oliver. Currently, laws regarding firearms vary widely from state to state, which often causes people to traveling to unwittingly break the law. Do you believe that individual states should continue to write their own laws, or that an amendment to the Constitution should be made that would allow the federal government to have more control over interstate legislation?
Well, I personally don't believe the federal government should be controlling the state's rights. And yes, I think it'll be left up to the individual state of what they want to do for its own rights.
Does anyone else have any comments on that front?
I agree.
This so happens, each state in the United States has had the choice to be a sovereign state via the 10th Amendment. This is an important means of checks and balances in our state. Each state is made up of individuals with different backgrounds and different beliefs. I dare say people in California don't look at gun rights the same way as the people in Alabama. I don't want the people in California telling me how Alabama should act and believe they're right on their rights. So if I think it's important, like I said, it's good checks and balances for our nation. If you don't like the way things are in that state, you can go to another state where you do. I know that's sometimes hard to just up and move. I'm not saying probably more likely you're not going to do that. Personally, I do believe and I hope that it does change. I'm a citizen of Alabama, but I'm also a citizen of the United States. Wherever I travel in what state that is, I should still carry those laws and rights as a citizen of Alabama. All of our further states, all the other states in the union, accept our driver's license. They also accept our marriage license. And this kind of jumps to another question, but because of that now, I believe it will come up that we're going to request each state to accept our gun permits through the last act of the Supreme Court truly to accept marriage license from other states, whether it be man and woman or woman and woman or man and man. So, governmental issued document. And again, I believe we should carry our rights. Each citizen of each state should carry those rights with them into the next state as long as they're a member of the United States.
And again, we'll go back to this question. I believe we can ask the other states to do that, but I believe that would take away that state's authority to decide what happens within that state. You know, I believe in most circumstances, they would honor it unless you were just completely acting out of ordinary. But, you know, I think all the surrounding states, you know, it's okay to have it. And they, even,
I think it's
17, I believe, is that is the number that honors our permit.
You know, we can talk about some things that, and I don't disagree with individuals, again, having guns and things to protect themselves. I mean, look at something here. Between 1982 and 2012, there were 6 mass shootings, 49 of them were with legal weapons. Half of all the shooters there used assault weapons and high capacity ammunition and things. You know, what I'm talking about sometimes is let's regulate those kinds of things. An individual wants to have a pistol or something, a shotgun or whatever in their home, but if we look at assault rifles and things, and we're going to be allowed to carry them openly, those things shoot and shoot miles or whatever. I'm not really into guns or anything. You know, I don't object to other people being involved in them, but I think some sensible stuff there, regulation, and I would be for at least some sensible stuff as it relates. Does everybody need a tank? Does everybody need a bazooka? It depends on how we're going to expand it. When we talk about an individual's rights to protect themselves, do I have to have a high-powered rifle that shoots armor-plated bullets and shoots 50 times? Do I have to have that? If you can't hit something in 5-10 shots, then you might need to go back to the range and practice a little bit. Those are the kinds of things that I'm talking about. I'm not wanting to infringe on anybody's rights and the right to do whatever they believe from their individual perspective. But as a collective and being part of the collective, I would have some rights as well to live in a situation where I feel safe. I wouldn't want somebody with high power ammo and stuff shooting around my house or whatever if we were neighbors or something like that. And we would want someone to have those things and for them to be quite sane, all that. So I'm not objecting to anything. I'm just some common sense stuff. From my perspective, to protect the collective.
Regulating the type of firearms that I'm allowed to have and regulating the amount of ammunition that I can have, again, is too much restriction. I don't have any control over that bad guy, what he's going to have shooting at me with, or how much ammunition he has. I don't have any control over that. We need to be talking about how to stop the bad guy and leave me alone.
Thank you, what's up, Gary? We have this thing that's called the Bill of Rights. Not the Bill of Wants, not the Bill of Needs, the Bill of Rights. Assault weapon is a term that was created by the media. Assault is an action. It's not a weapon. I have a couple of what the media calls assault weapons, and they've never done anything. They're a lot of fun to shoot, but I enjoy them. I hope I never have to use one for my personal protection. Do I believe you ought to be able to walk around toting an AR-15 or M-16 with a 30 or 100 round magazine? No, but it causes some civil unrest. But again, when you outlaw guns, only the bad folks are gonna have them. And if they can't buy them, they'll steal them. If they can't buy them or steal them, they will make them.
I'm about to say this, and then we'll move on to something else. But he spoke of civil unrest, and brought up a very good point. I believe I could actually show you on the hands, but there's been a large number of people in here that's been around guns, that has shot guns, that enjoys guns. But there is another majority of people that has no clue about guns. And if you get a gentleman, I'm gonna pick on Gary because he's my friend. If you use him, for example, and he walks into a business, a restaurant, and he's carrying two Colt 45s and a Western-type holster, and he's, the first thing people's gonna pick up is on your appearance. They don't care what kind of gun you got, they're gonna pick up on your appearance. How many times have you heard people say, well, he had all black clothes on him, and he had a gun on, he's up to something. Have y'all heard that? That's exactly what people get in their mind, is that they're bad. So, and that'll take us to another question in a few minutes, and I'll finish that up.
If anyone in the audience has any questions that they would like to be asked, you have a number inside your program, so you can go ahead and text it there, and we'll read through and we'll make sure to get those asked. All right, so the next question, what terms do you think gun owners should have to abide by?
I guess my clarify terms. Would that be, I guess I need some clarification on the terms. I don't think they should abide by anything other than just what we talked about. If they're going to carry a gun, then they need to be respectful to other people's rights. Where one right, or your rights stop, another one begins, I would just, be professional, be trained, know how to use it if you have to. I don't think that's asking too much. Some people has no idea what a gun can do, I think you need to know how to use it. I believe that would be the only, and I guess that would be a self-proclaimed term to just know how to use it if you have to, and know how to protect it, keep from somebody taking it from you.
Well, I'm big on individual responsibility. Until I harm you, I shouldn't be punished. So, no terms.
The only terms are state and federal laws. As long as you're a law-abiding citizen and you follow the laws of your state and your country, that's the only terms that you should have to be, you should only have to follow. Our group, Bama Carry, some of y'all have our brochures. Our main thing is education and training. We want you to know proper gun etiquette. We want you to know what the laws are, so you don't break them. That's why We urge everyone that's interested in this to get involved with that.
I think there's some sensible things that people should do there. And this is just my opinion there. Open carries where things are visible. I think the sheriff spoke to that. If someone's wanting to carry a gun in a lawful situation and they're wanting to carry it for protection, and I'm just putting myself in a bad guy's situation, and that's what I do as a psychologist. You put yourself in a situation. And you know, if I were out to get you, and you had an open gun, do you think that I would come and just challenge you and say, hey, you want to shoot out? I'd light you up before you could get your hands on that trigger. That's what criminals really do, right? Bullies are not gonna fight people who are gonna fight back. And so, to me, if we're carrying a gun for our protection there, and I'm a bad guy, and I know you've got a gun, and I've thought this thing out, you're the first person I'm gonna take out. The first person. And when I see you open carry, I'm gonna take you out the game. First up. Right? Some of these individuals that are really bad guys, they're not stupid. Some of them. And so, when we have a sensible thing to me is that if I were going to carry a gun, you'd never know that I've got it. I wouldn't want you to know that I've got it. It would only then, if something were to come down, that I would allow you to see it, and if I pulled it out, I would light you up. It wouldn't be a pulling out saying, hey, stop. If I pulled it out, I would light you up. If I were going to be an individual that carried one, and I'm carrying it for my protection. And if I basically saw you walk in with one and it's shown and I can see it, as the sheriff said, I'm a little skeptical of you. So I'm gonna be sitting back there and I might even have my hand on the trigger waiting for you to do something. So to me, some sensible ways of carrying a weapon to me would be concealed. For no one knows that you've got it. Why would you want to, I mean, what's the big deal walking around saying, hey, I've got this rifle on my shoulder today? Everybody looks and sees it. The idea is that I don't want you to know what I've got. It's only then, when you make your wrong move, that I take you out of the game. And that's me thinking from the perspective of a bad guy.
First, I want to say one thing about that. First of all, I'm not opposed to anyone who wants to carry their pistol openly. You know, there's not a law that keeps a person from doing that. They're perfectly legal to carry that gun openly. I personally am not against that, you know, if that's what you want to do. I'm speaking myself personally. Only time I carry my gun openly is unless I'm, you know, they know who I am. You know, I have a gun, I have a badge, people know who I am. If I'm off duty, I have a gun, you know, and I keep it on me, I keep it concealed. Very few times do I go anywhere without a gun, but that's just, you know, performance of my job. I want to be able, if something comes up in that situation, I don't want to use my gun. I hope I never have to. I hope it's just a weight hanging on my side, but in that situation and the performance of my duties, I want to be able to have it. And that's speaking from law enforcement.
The manner that a person carries their firearm is an individual choice, and there's two sides to the coin, and there are valuable ideas on both ways, concealed and open. There's good and bad for both. So I always refrain from getting into any type of argument. I love to discuss, but I won't argue with anybody. If they want it, it's an individual choice. You carry the way that you wish to carry. I mean, I could come up with stories to where I came out victorious, the same as others can come up with stories where I came out defeated. There's all types of scenarios that we could all come up with, regardless, it's personal choice on that.
Of course, I know there were earrings, I believe that's like our shirts on. A lot of people don't realize this. They just saw it in the media. And like, the news media is real good about hyping things up. Yes, there was quite a few stories about people carrying AR-15s and AK-47s on their shoulder and walking into stores, restaurants. Y'all know where that was at? It was in Texas. You know why they did that in Texas? Because they were trying to get out of places in the world, in the United States, why would Texas not allow open carry of a firearm? Or handgun, correct? Yeah, correct. They would not allow the open carry of a handgun. But guess what? Our Bill of Rights, our Second Amendment, gave us the right to bear arms. They were refused the right to carry a handgun on their side openly. And for that reason, we're willing to start carrying our ARs and AKs. They were in a legal battle with their legislature to get open carry passed. I'm here to tell you, there ain't nobody wants to carry an AK-47 or AR-15 on their side all day long every day. It's uncomfortable, it's aggravating, the strap hurts. We don't want to have to do that. They were going to the extreme to say, I want to open carry. Concealed carry, open carry is a personal choice, but when you concealed carry and when you're forced to concealed carry by law, it limits the size of the gun, how many rounds you can carry. I'm a man with big hands. Yeah, I concealed carry too, but I have to concealed carry a little small gun that barely fits in my hand and it limits me to 7 rounds. And there might be, I hope to God I never use it. But it's pretty possible 7 rounds might not get me out of a bad situation sometimes if I ever get put in one. The gun on my side fits my hand. I can hold it and use it so much safer. And it also holds 16 rounds. So that kind of gets into a little bit more explaining the AR-15, AK-47 walk around your shoulder. Honestly, there's nobody I know that wants to do that.
We're actually going to stop with these questions now. We're going to ask some of the questions from the audience. The first question that we got was, what would be your idea of gun control? And just try and keep it like shorter. You all know. Yeah. So what would be your idea of gun control?
Using two hands and hitting what I'm shooting at. I was going to say the exact same thing. Using both hands and hitting what you're aiming at.
Basic stuff, again, individuals having their guns have been concealed, not having these huge weapons that are open, not having any of the assault rifles and things being transported in their car and around and about that. People can have what they wish in their homes, but maybe, and I'm talking about just some sensible stuff there, not doing away with someone's Second Amendment rights. It's just some basic stuff, again, so that we don't become a society that feels that we have to be protected at all times. We've got law enforcement to do that, and more often than not, if you're going to have trouble with someone, in more cases than not, it's going to be people that you know, these are people that you have a relationship with. Most people don't have to worry about, usually, some stranger coming up and doing something to them. The people that you have to worry about is those people that you love and you care about. you look at the stats, a lot of times, and we've got these mass shooters or whatever, but how often is it that you got family members doing things to each other, neighbors doing things to each other, co-workers doing things to each other? And when we see those particular things happen, and I've mentioned this before, most of the time, when you look at people being assaulted and those things, it's usually by people that they know.